Hello students, in this class we are going to learn lesson number 5, India at Play. Games have been a part of life in India. Many games have originated in India and some are being reinvented today. The Pro Kabaddi League is brought out Kabaddi out of the shadows, while the IPL, Indian Premier League, has doubled the enthusiasm for cricket. The sporting scene in India is vibrant today as we experiment and create new and exciting possibilities. When we think of sports, games like cricket, football and tennis come to mind. When we think about games, usually what games come to our mind? We think about only cricket, football and tennis. We rarely think of games such as Kabaddi, Gilli Danda and Kit Kit, though they have been with us for centuries and are played enthusiastically in almost every village and city of India. Hardly we think of games like Kabaddi, Gilli Danda and Kit Kit. These games with us for many years ago and they are played with interest and almost in every village and city of India. What are these games? Where do they come from? And what do they mean to us? Let's read on. What are these games and how they started and what do they convey us? Let's see in this lesson. In the history of humankind, sports has always played an important role. Humankind, the human race. In the history of human race, sports always have played an important role, both as a source of amusement and a mean of keeping the mind and body fit. Amusement, entertainment. In the ancient India, people were engaging themselves in play as a source of entertainment and the keeping one's body and mind fit. In ancient India, as with many ancient civilizations, ancient means old civilization, an advanced state of human society. In old India, we have many civilization like Indus civilization. The people in those civilization, it was not enough to gain knowledge. The health and fitness of one's body was equally important. In that civilization's people, they are not giving importance only to acquire the knowledge, they are also giving equally importance to one's health and body fitness. Long before India had embraced cricket and football. Embraced means accept. Long, many years ago, India had accepted, welcomed games like cricket and football. Such games such as kite flying, kabaddi and kho-kho, to name a few, were played by both by kings and commoners. Such games as kite flying, kabaddi and kho-kho, and few more. These games were played by kings and also played by the common people. These games do not boast of having sports stars like Sachin Tendulkar or MC Mary Kom, but they are immensely popular even today. Boast, to speak with pride. Immensely, truly. Here, sports stars like Sachin Tendulkar, MC Mary Kom, Saina Nehwal or Sushil Kumar. They are great personalities in sports arena. For example, nowadays Sachin Tendulkar is not playing in international level. although we are watching cricket, the viewership of cricket is not come down. Interestingly, the earliest forms of some of these games existed even before the Mahabharata was written. Existed, survive. Even before the Mahabharata was written, these games are existed. It was played being in different forms. Kho-kho is one such example, a game of great agility and alertness. In ancient times, it was played on rats or chariots and was known as Rathera. The writer has given a beautiful example of Kho-kho here, the game of great swiftness and awareness. In ancient time, it was played on rats or chariots. Agility means swiftness, alertness, fully aware of, attentive. Chariots, four-wheeled pleasure carriage. In ancient time, Kho-kho was played on rats and it is known as Rathera. Why we called Rathera here means the Kho-kho was played on rats. In this modern version, a chaser from one team tries to touch an opponent from the other team to get them out. In the nowadays, all of you know how the Kho-kho is played, how we are playing Kho-kho. In modern variety, nowadays, a chaser from one team tries to touch an opponent. Here, opponent means a person who is an opposing side of the game. And he, from the opponent, from the other team to get them out. The chaser may pass his or her task to a teammate sitting on the central line made on a rectangular field by touching the teammate's back and shouting Kho. You might have seen how the player sitting in the Kho-kho field, they are sitting opposite and on the central line made a rectangular field by touching one's teammate's back and they cried aloud with Kho. The team that takes the shortest time to dismiss its rivals wins. The team takes shorter time to free or release competitors wins. Another game of touching and dismissing opponents is Kabaddi. Another game like Kho-kho is touching and releasing the opponents is Kabaddi. It is said to have originated from the Mahabharata incident of Abhimanyu getting trapped in a Chakravyuha created by his enemies. Chakravyuha means a complex battle formation that is difficult to break. The Kabaddi was started from the Mahabharata incident. The Abhimanyu got trapped. Here, trapped means to keep somebody in a dangerous situation or place. He trapped in Chakravyuha created by his enemies. Who had created Chakravyuha? Yes, Abhimanyu's enemies created Chakravyuha. Kabaddi is a game of breath control, raiding and dodging. Here, raiding means entering the area of opposing team. Dodging, avoiding by moving quickly. Kabaddi is a game of breath holding, breath controlling and entering the area of opposing team and with quick movements. A player raids the opposing team, tries to touch an opponent and return to his or her team, all the while chanting Kabaddi, Kabaddi and holding the breath. A player enters the opposing team, tries to touch an opponent and return his or her team. While he is returning, he he is chanting. Chanting means to repeat. He is repeating kabaddi, kabaddi. And he is controlling the breath. At the Asian Games so far, India has always won gold in kabaddi. Children, Asian Games held once in 4 years. Till date, India has always won gold medal in kabaddi. Another popular sport dating back to the ancient times is wrestling. We come across from ancient time to till now, the popular game is wrestling. The Mahabharata mentions Duryodhana and Bhima as accomplished wrestlers. The Vyasa Maharishi was mentioned in the Mahabharata. Duryodhana and Bhima was as masterly wrestlers. The most accomplished means masterly. The most famous freestyle version of wrestling in India is Kushti. Kushti is most famous freestyle variety in India, which symbolizes bravery and strength, which indicates bravery and strength of a player. Pahalwans or wrestlers generally practice in akharas or wrestling schools and dangals. Annual village competitions decide a new champion every year. Wrestlers are known as pahalwans. They practice in akharas, wrestling schools and dangals. In that, these are held in a village. These competitions choose a champion in every year. Many Indian wrestlers such as Sushil Kumar, Geeta Fogat and Babita Kumari have gained international fame and become the face of Indian wrestlers. We have some great wrestlers like Sushil Kumar, Geeta Fogat and Babita Kumari. In India, sports also has a role in the celebration of festivals. In India, sports also play an important role in celebration of festivals. Kite flying or patang bazi, played passionately by the nobility during medieval times, now marks many joyous occasions in India. Passionately means strong feelings. Nobility, a class of people of high rank. Kite flying is known as patang bazi. It is played with strong feeling and a class of high people. It marked with many happiness events in India. The International Kite Festival is held every year in Gujarat during Makara Sankranti. When is International Kite Festival is celebrating? The International Kite Festival is celebrating in Gujarat during the Makara Sankranti. On 15th August, the sky is dotted with kites as people celebrate Independence Day. When we celebrate Independence Day? We celebrate Independence Day on 15th August. On 15th August in Gujarat, the sky is marked with full of kites as people celebrate Independence Day. Kite battles are also held where one kite flyer entangles the string of his or her kite around and tries to cut it. Kite battles. Here another game which is in that where one kite flyer twist together the string of his or hers kite around the another's kite flyers and tries to cut it the string. Entangles means to involve in. We shall continue the lesson in the next video. Thank you.